This demonstration video will show the process of modifying the mesh to capture key features in the area around the structure. We have opened an SMS project of our demo site. This site is a bridge crossing over the Musselshell River in rural Montana. First, let's zoom in on the bridge crossing. As you can see, the channel for the existing mesh has been represented using the patch mesh type to create quadrilateral elements. To include a pressure flow bridge in the model, we first need to modify the mesh to align element edges to the bridge deck and piers. At this point, we could digitize arcs to represent the bridge deck edges and piers. Often we have these details in a CAD file. Let's read in a CAD file for this demo site. To better see the CAD data, let's turn off the existing mesh. Remember, this is just reference data at this point. To use it to create a mesh, we first need to convert the CAD data to feature objects. This is done by right-clicking on the CAD data and selecting Convert Feature Objects. Let's select these options in the Clean dialog. This creates a new coverage called CAD, as you can see here in the Project Explorer. Next, let's copy the mesh generator coverage and rename it to Proposed. This way we can add the new bridge feature arcs to the coverage and keep the original mesh generator coverage for the existing mesh. Now let's go back to the CAD coverage and copy the feature objects representing the bridge to the new proposed coverage. We first select all the arcs. Then we right-click and select Copy to Coverage. We select the proposed coverage in this menu. The bridge feature arcs are now included in the proposed coverage. Now we are ready to connect the bridge arcs to the existing channel arcs. First, we will split the channel arcs by creating two new arcs across the channel near the bridge. Next, we'll delete the channel arcs crossing the bridge area. Then we'll connect the existing channel arcs to the new bridge details by following the channel banks, using the image as a guide. Since we have deleted and created new arcs, we need to build polygons again. Before we do so, let's use the Clean tool to be sure the new feature objects connect. Let's change the snapping tolerance to 1. Now let's click on the Build Polygons macro to build the polygons. Let's use the Select Polygons tool to review the polygons. Note how the polygons are created for the approach areas, the piers, and the bridge deck. Now we need to edit each of these polygons to refine the mesh in the bridge area. For example, let's edit this upstream approach polygon. Let's add 20 vertices along this bank arc. Let's add 5 vertices on this arc to match the number of elements across the channel. Finally, let's add 3 vertices to each of the bridge deck arcs. We now have a reasonable paving mesh that will be created for this polygon. Next, we'll edit the polygons for the bridge deck. Let's edit this center bridge deck polygon. We'll select the end arcs and the downstream arcs and add 3 vertices. Now we'll change the mesh type to patch and preview. We get this error because there are extra nodes along the bridge deck arcs. Let's select these nodes, then select the merge option to merge the arcs for this polygon. We now changed the patch mesh type again. Note that we now have a good quadrilateral mesh for the bridge deck. Also, let's select both pier polygons and change the mesh to none. No elements will be generated in these polygons, creating a hole in the mesh to represent the piers. We could continue to edit the mesh parameters for all the new polygons. In the interest of time, we won't do all of them in this demo. Once all the new polygons are defined, we would be ready to create the mesh. This is done by right-clicking on the proposed coverage and selecting Map to 2D Mesh. Since we haven't defined all the polygons, we won't do this. Now we'll show an example of how this might look from a mesh created previously. Note the use of quadrilateral elements with the edges aligning with the bridge deck. This concludes the demonstration for modifying the mesh in preparation for adding a bridge structure to an SRH 2D model. You will follow similar steps as you do the first exercise for this lesson.